Good afternoon, students. And as you know that yesterday we have learnt about the first chapter of class 6 geography. And the chapter name is the Earth in the Solar System. And so many interesting things and important things we have understood from there. I hope you all understood those points. Before we start today's topic, I hope you clear the topics which we discussed yesterday, like full moon night or Purnima or new moon night, that is Amavasya, along with that celestial body, along with that stars, and about about some other things also, like constellations and about planets. All these things, pole star, all these things we understood yesterday, which I have taught. So, apart from these important things, we understood about the solar family, about the planets. So, today we'll learn about new topic. But student, I want to remind you that in the constellation, as you know that I have given two examples, Ursa Major or Paul Bear and that Saptarishi. So students, that pattern you must know that. So pattern you will practice in your home, and you will pattern is very important. Pattern you see, I will show you that pattern also in next classes. So today students, we will learn about new topic. As I have told you, yesterday we completed about the planets. As we have understood, 8 planets are there, the fact which will help you to understand about the names of 8 planets, that also I have told you, along with that sun I have told you. So student, today we will learn a new topic like Earth. So student, the Earth, where we stay, the planet where we stay, so that planet is known as very important for us, because the earth is the third nearest planet to the sun. So the Earth is the third nearest planet to the sun in the size, and it is the largest planet. It is the fifth largest planet. So it's according to its size, it is the fifth largest planet, and it is third nearest planet to the sun. So according to the distance, it is the third nearest planet to the sun. So it is slightly flattened at the poles, in the north pole and in the south pole, it is slightly flattened. Its shape is described as a geoid. Geoid means it like a earth-like shape. Earth-like shape means slightly flattened in both the poles, north pole and south pole. So student, this is the first paragraph which is written in your book. So we'll discuss more condition favorable. Next paragraph, as it is written, that condition favorable to the support life are probably found only on the Earth. So student, when I will discuss more about the Earth is called a unique planet. As I hope you all understood this. Why it is unique planet for us? Why it is called unique planet? Because the conditions which are required to survive, those conditions are available in the Earth. That is why human beings and all the living beings are survive here. Which, and in other 7 planets, those favorable climate and favorable things are not there. So when it is said the Earth is a unique planet, we'll discuss more about that. What are the things favor to the living beings? So in your book it is written that we must know about the thing which are written in your NCERT book. It is written that conditions favorable to support life are probably found only on the Earth. So the condition which are required, that is available only on the Earth. The Earth is neither too hot or not too cold. So it means that the favorable temperature, what we require, that we get in the Earth. That is why we adjust in that temperature. The Earth, it has water and air, which are very essential for our survival. So we want water for drink, and we want oxygen for breathing. So those things, water and air, we get in the earth. Along with that, the air has life supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these reasons, the earth is a unique planet in the solar system. So student, as we understood from this paragraph, like the favorable climate, along with that water, air, and so all these things available in the in our planet. That is why we call the earth is a unique planet. So student, next, along with that unique planet, the earth is also called a blue planet. So why it is called a blue planet? So it is written that from the outer space, the earth appears blue. If we look to the earth from the outer space, from the space, it looks like a blue planet. So why it is looked blue planet? Because 2/3 surface is covered by water. So the 2/3 of the earth surface that is covered by water, from the two parts that is covered with the water. That is why it appears blue from the space. So students, this is all about the earth. As I told you, you need to remember about the why earth is called a unique planet and why earth looks blue from the sky. Along with that, it is the third planet according to the distance, and it is the fifth planet according to the size. So student, next topic is moon. So student, moon, when I said it is very important to know that is a natural satellite of earth and which is accompanied to the earth. So it is written that our earth has only one satellite, that is the moon. Its diameter means its length is 1/4 that of the earth. So its length is 1/4 from the three part, one part from the three part of the earth. It is 1/4 of the three part of the earth. It is distance. It appears so big because it is very nearer to us. Next, it is that it appears too big because it is nearest our planet than other celestial bodies. So it is about 384,400 kilometers away from the earth. So this is the distance between the earth and moon, 384,400 kilometers from the earth, the distance between the earth and the moon. So students, yesterday also we learned about the distance between the earth and sun, that is 150 million kilometers from the earth. So student, these distances and these points, the important point which I am repeating, those important points you write in your copy and you send me. If you send me any doubt where you have, so that I will reply you. Next paragraph is written about the earth is the moon moves around the earth in about 27 days. The moon takes 27 days to rotate to one rotation. One round. So student, it is round means you can understand the revolution. The exact word you can use that the earth moves around the earth. The moon moves around the earth it takes 27 days to move around the earth. And along with that, it takes exactly the same time to complete one spin. So the moon doesn't have the favorable condition for life. So in the moon, student, that is as the research are going, the scientists and astronauts are researching about that, whether life can support there on the earth surface, on the moon surface or not. But it is till now, that is in research. But what we understood till now, that is not favorable condition for supporting the life. So what are the things are there? It has neither water nor air. It has mountains, plains, and depressions on its surface. So it's mountains, plains, and depression means about the storms are coming there. So that is why it doesn't support the life. So student, in this space, along with this topic, some other important informations are there. I want you should remember this and understand this important facts. Like student, it is written that Neil Armstrong was the first person to step the step on the surface of the moon. And when he stepped on the moon on 21st July 1969, on 21st July 1969, Neil Armstrong was the first person who stepped on the surface of the moon. You can note down this. Next is satellite. When we talk about the satellite, like moon is a natural satellite of the earth, along with that natural satellite, some artificial satellites are also there. Artificial means those who the satellite which are made by the human being. So now we have to understood that what is satellite. A satellite is a celestial body which is in the space, you know, which we see on the sky, night sky, that moves around the planets in the same way as the planets move around the sun. So a satellite is a celestial body that moves around the planet and revolves it revolves around the planet in the same way like our earth moves around the sun. And as you know that the earth takes 365 days and 6 hours to rotate the earth, but we don't say that 6 hours, only we tell about the 365 days. So human made satellite. So what is human made satellite? So human made satellite is an artificial body. It is designed by scientists to gather information about the universe or for communication. It is carried by a rocket placed on the orbit around the earth. Orbit means it is the path with which our earth or the planets move. That is called the orbit. That also we have understood from the previous topic, what is about orbit. So student, next is that example when we will talk about, then examples are INSAT, EDUSAT. These are the examples of artificial satellites. So student, next thing we'll learn about what is asteroids and meteorites. So student, when we will discuss about asteroids, as it is written that apart from the stars, planets and satellites, there are numerous tiny body which also move around the sun. So student, we know that around the sun different things moves, like the stars, planets and satellites. So asteroids are also some teeny bodies, numerous means large, various, many teeny, numerous means many teeny, tiny bodies, they moves around the sun. So these bodies, these tiny small bodies, they are known as the asteroids. So they are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. So they are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. So in between the Mars and Jupiter, we found that. So student, one picture is there in this chapter about the distance from the sun. The planets are arranged. So you will see in that picture, between the Mars and Jupiter, one orbit is there. So in that orbit, asteroids are found, large tiny bodies. So exactly it is written that they are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter, and scientists are of the view that asteroids are part of a planet which exploded many years back. So student, as we see in the between the Mars and Jupiter, the orbit which was there, small, large tiny bodies are there. Scientists have believed that many years back, so planets were exploded. So from the remains of those planets, they are now in the form of tiny bodies. So exactly, asteroids are tiny body which moves around the sun. So student, these are very important topic as you are reading geography. These things about the solar system, earth and the space, sun, about the planets, you have to understand about that. Along with that student, you keep practicing on maps and draw these planets and label these planets and write down these things. If you will not understand and you will miss to understand this topic, it means that you will miss very important informations. Okay, coming back to the topic after asteroids, meteoroids. So student, when we'll talk about meteoroids, the small pieces of rocks which moves around the sun. So meteoroids are small pieces of rocks, they are move around the sun. So sometimes students, these meteoroids come nearer to the earth and tend to drop upon in. So during the process of friction with the earth and with the air, they get hit. So the meteoroids, when they come inside of the earth, they friction with the air and they get hits, and they get heat up and burn the meteoroids burn in the air only and in the atmosphere only. It causes a flash to light. So sometimes a meteor without being completely burnt, that falls on the surface of the earth and creates a hollow. So students, after these meteoroids and asteroids, another important thing which I want to discuss with you, galaxy. So as if you remember that in the last classes, when we discuss about the galaxy, about the universe, I have told you about the galaxy. Still again, I want to remind for you that a galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars. So a galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds and dust, clouds of dust and gases. So a galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds of dust and gases. So this is the definition of galaxy. Next is universe. So what is universe? As I told you in the previous class also, there are millions of such galaxies. So millions of galaxies make together universe. So student, these are some of the important topics, the important points about this the first step of the geography. And the question answer, if you will see also, already we have told about, and from the chapter it is mentioned there, how does a planet differ from a star. As I told you that solar system, and name all the planets according to their distance from the sun. That also very easy answers, that is I have discussed and told. And why is the earth called a unique planet? How do we only one side of the moon always we see that? What is universe, just now I told. And along with that, tick the correct answer, fill in the blanks. Very easy answer student, I have already told. And if anywhere you feel difficulties, you can in the comment box you can ask me, I will reply you. And thank you for the attending the class and seeing this video. And in the next video I will tell you about the second chapter. And every day one chapter will be completed, and which will helpful for you. Thank you for participating.